So, while the monks were gathered in the hall and were discussing Mitta-gandhaka, the Buddha entered and asked what they were discussing. "Monks, this is not the first time that this man has received great honor due to this woman. In the past, when he was an animal, he made many friends and was able to save his family's life because of her advice." Upon the monk's requests, the Buddha told this story of the past. A long time ago, when Brahmadatta was reigning in Benares, men often went to the forest to hunt and look for meat. A male hawk lived in that forest. He wanted to marry a female hawk, but before she would agree, she asked him, "Do you have any friends?"
"I do not."
"Then how will you protect me and any babies we might have from predators?"
"I don't know."
"If you want me to agree to marry you, you must be able to protect me and any babies we might have. In order to do that, you must go out and make some friends."
"Who would I make friends with?"
"There's a king osprey who lives on the eastern shore. Go and make friends with him. There's also a lion, king of the beasts, who lives on the northern shore. Go and make friends with him. There's also a great turtle, who lives on a small island near the center of the forest. Go and make friends with him." And so, the hawk followed the she-hawk's advice and went to see the king osprey. When he arrived, he said to the king osprey,
"Oh, great bird, king of birds, I wish to be a friend to you."
The osprey asked,
"Tell me, hawk, I am bigger and stronger than you. Why would I need you as a friend?"
The hawk responded as the female hawk had instructed him.
So that in your need, you can call upon me. And in my need, I can call upon you. There are times in everyone's life where a helping hand could mean the difference between life and death."
And so, the hawk and King Osprey became friends. The hawk then went to the lion. When he got there, he humbly said,
"Oh, great king of beasts, powerful lion, I desire to become friends with you."
"Why would I need a friend like you?"
The hawk then answered as he was instructed,
"Great lion, it is true that you are the most powerful and grandest of all beasts, yet there are things that even you cannot conquer alone. With friends, hard tasks can become easier, and dangers one can't overcome may be mitigated with the help of others."
And so, the hawk and the lion agreed to be friends. And then he went to the turtle and said,
"Sir Turtle, I wish to create a friendship with you."
"Sir Hawk, you live in the sky, while I live on the land and in the sea. Why do we need to be friends?"
As instructed, the hawk said,
Precisely for that reason, Grand Turtle. We each have skills that are unique from each other. This means we can create benefits where the other cannot. Together as friends, we can benefit each other and create opportunities for each other."
And with that, the turtle agreed to be friends. Afterwards, The female hawk agreed to marry him, and the two lived together in a great tree in a nest that they made. After a while, they had two baby birds. It just so happened that at that time, some hunters were out hunting for meat. All they had caught was a fish. Tired and annoyed, they decided to cook the fish and have their meal. They settled underneath the hawk's tree and started a fire. The smoke rose up to the tree and began to irritate the baby birds. As they were only babies, they did not have control of themselves and began to squeal. The hawk and his wife tried to shield the babies from the smoke, but were unsuccessful. The baby birds, choking on the smoke, started to scream. The hunters down below heard the sounds and became excited at the prospect of adding bird meat to their meal. The frantic female hawk said,
"This kind of situation is exactly why I had you make friends. Go and call upon the great osprey and ask him for help. The lives of our young are at stake."
The hawk flew off in a panic and arrived at the home of the king osprey.
"Great king of birds, I must call upon our friendship and request help. My children are in danger."
Without a second thought, the osprey took off with the hawk. While the hawk and the osprey were flying, the hunters lit torches and began to climb up the tree to the baby birds. It was very dark, so they needed the light of the torches to see. As the hunters climbed higher and higher, the female hawk could only sit and hope that their friend the osprey would come to the rescue. The osprey arrived at the tree and watched the hunters climb closer and closer. When they were a few body lengths away, the osprey took off for the water. The osprey dove into the water and got himself as wet as possible. He flew right above the climbing hunters and shook off all the water to extinguish their torches. The hunters were livid. They were hungry and determined to get those birds. However, they couldn't see without their torches, so they climbed down to relight them. The hunters angrily rekindled the fire and lit their torches. They then proceeded to climb back up the tree to the crying baby birds. The osprey waited for the hunters to get close and then flew off to gather water. Again, he came back and extinguished the flame of their torches. This happened many times. The hunters were determined, but so was the osprey. The osprey had given his word that if called upon, he would do whatever he could to help his friend, and he was determined to keep his word. However, having given his all, the osprey eventually collapsed.
"My friend, they will climb up once they have rested and relit their torches. I cannot fly anymore. If you have other friends, you should seek them out now, or else we are all dead."
The female hawk said,
"Husband, go to your friend the turtle, for he may be able to help us."
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.